A young female actor who was traveling in her car was kidnapped and sexually assaulted. It was a crime that Kerala watched in shock. And for years, the people of Kerala have been obsessively following it. There are a set of villains. There is an actor who was sexually assaulted. There is a superstar who is accused of conspiring and paying these criminals to do this sexual assault. And then there is a Malayalam film industry and the Kerala society.
There was so much anger towards this actress that she had lost acting opportunities because Dilip had removed her from multiple movies, and they used to work a lot together. And ultimately she was isolated in the industry, and then this act of revenge happens. And he'd become this sort of figure who'd gone to jail, and then everyone wanted to talk about him, and then he'd come out, he'd found his way back into cinema, that nobody wanted to ruffle his feathers because everybody would say it's better not to mess with him.
There have been so many setbacks. There have been clear injustices from the court on this victim in many different ways. And still we are not having enough conversation about that, right?
According to the police, the videos were recorded to sort of threaten her and basically tell her that if you speak about this, we will release these videos. The process of justice itself, or the process of trying to get some form of justice, can itself be a process of trauma.
Women are subjected to violence not just once but multiple times if they have the courage to actually go file a complaint.
This wasn't an act of violence that just happened to the survivor. It had its ripple effects on the industry.
I had a bag which said, "I am a feminichi." It was such a powerful statement also, right? Women coming out and talking about their experiences.
Weinstein movement, what most of the women told me, was help them not to look crazy. Because when they came out and they started saying that this isn't a one-off incident, there is a lot of abuse within the industry, a lot of the men reacted to them saying, "Oh, you're just being hysterical. Why didn't you say it back then? Why is all of this coming up now? These are just angry feminists." Feminichi became the term that came out at that point. So now when they go on set, men refuse to sit next to them saying, "Oh, what if you do a Me Too? I don't know when you're going to complain about me." So women have also felt isolated, that speaking up has made them tough to work with, that they have lost opportunities, that men don't want to work with them.